Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Token Post Interview. Today we have invited someone very special, someone who is referred to as the Bitcoin Jesus, and who will be Carnival here today. Welcome.
Thank you. I prefer to be called Roger, just for the record.
So Roger, let's dig into the interview. I hate to compare Bitcoin Cash. You're referred to as the early investor, the founder of Bitcoin. However, you are now an avid supporter of the Bitcoin Cash program and recently stated that the products out of the Bitcoin Cash platform is very prominent. So what's your thought behind that?
Yeah, I'm excited about Bitcoin Cash today for the exact same reason I got excited about BTC back in 2011, because Bitcoin Cash can become money for the entire world. It can allow anyone anywhere to send and receive any amount of money with anyone anywhere instantly, basically for free. BTC can no longer do that. Bitcoin Cash does. So Bitcoin Cash is Bitcoin. BTC is a science project without a white paper, and who knows what they're doing. I wish them good luck, but it's not Bitcoin. Bitcoin Cash is Bitcoin, and that's why I support Bitcoin Cash today. And if you haven't tried it or you're not sure, try using BTC, try using BCH, it's clear. BCH works, it works amazingly well, the transactions are lightning fast, and basically for free. It's what the entire world wants, right? Frictionless money for the world, that's Bitcoin Cash.
Talking about lightning speed, you're here today showing around the Bitcoin.com wallet.
Yeah.
So would you care to show that to our audience?
Sure. I already set you up with one before we started filming, but it literally takes longer to download the app, or it takes me longer to figure out which pocket my phone is in. It takes longer to do that than it does to actually start using the app. So if you install the Bitcoin.com wallet on your phone and go to free.bitcoin.com, we're giving out free Bitcoin Cash to anyone anywhere in the world through our faucet. And that's how I received my first Bitcoin ever, was from one of these faucets on the internet. A faucet is no longer possible on BTC. On Bitcoin Cash, of course it is, because Bitcoin Cash is more has more Bitcoin-ness about it than BTC does at this point. So
would you care to show that to our audience on the camera?
Yeah, let's do it.
I know I took part in this event before, but I'll give it back to you if you want.
That's okay. No. You're going to share it with a friend. So
Sure.
So open your wallet app here. Yep. And you're on the send page. You're going to hit the Bucky or receive page, right? So this is your Bitcoin Cash address that I'll then scan with my app here. So I'll scan that, and I'll send you another 10,000 won here. So I'll do that, and it's calculating the fee to do that. And I'm roaming on my Japanese phone in Korea, so my internet's slower than it would be normally. The fee to do that is 2 Korean won. So now I hit slide to send, and we'll wait another second or so. And if you're on Wi-Fi or good internet, it's much faster. Sent. Boom, boom, boom. Received, just like that.
So. Took like 10 seconds.
Yeah. And to install the app, you didn't have to give your name, you didn't have to give your email, you didn't have to give your tax ID number. It works for anyone, anywhere in the world, just like that with the Bitcoin.com wallet. Get some free Bitcoin Cash at free.bitcoin.com and tell a friend.
Thank you so much. So moving on to some recent events, I saw the news on how you claim that Ripple can freeze accounts.
Yeah, I was wrong about that, and I apologize.
You reclaimed that, yeah. Could you care to give a bit of explanation on how the things like panned out?
Sure, it's an example of like the real big problem out there with fake news. There's a bunch of fake news out there telling lies about all sorts of things, not just cryptocurrency, but all sorts of things in the world. And the sad fact of the matter is I was fooled by some of these news articles claiming that Ripple can freeze anybody's account at any time for any reason. And if that were true, that wouldn't make it a cryptocurrency. It would be no different than your normal bank account. But I was wrong about that. I apologize. And all I can do is do my best not to be fooled by the fake news. And I implore all of you out there watching this, there's a lot of fake news out there about Bitcoin Cash saying bad things about it. It's not true. Bitcoin Cash works amazingly well for anyone, anywhere. Give it a try. That's the best way to understand is try it. And do your own research. Don't believe the fake news. So
talking about news, Bitcoin.com is also partially a news media.
Yeah.
So from your perspective, where does the future of cryptocurrency media lie?
Cryptocurrency media, huh? I think on some of these decentralized, uncensorable platforms. So check out Memo.cash, BlockPress.com, DTube. Like, there's all sorts of social media platforms that are coming out that nobody can control or censor or manipulate. Like, that's really, really exciting stuff. So I think that sort of thing is probably the future.
So you're here in Korea taking part at Huobi Carnival.
Yep.
And you are an avid fan of the Korean, like, fandom of cryptocurrency.
Sure.
So what catches your eye?
Everything here is exciting. Korean people love digital currencies, right? This is one of the leading places in the world. And one of the big differences, too, between, like, Japan versus Korea, for example, everyone in Japan is so shy and scared, they're scared to even install a new app on their phone, whereas I tell a Korean person, hey, install this app, let me show you how this works. Like, yeah, let me give it a try, and they're not scared at all, so it's fantastic.
So, but here in Korea, the people are still focusing on the investing part, not the project, not the technology itself. So if you don't mind, could just send out a message telling people that, hey, you should look into this. This is something you should study.
Yeah, this is definitely, this is one of the most important world-changing technologies in the history of the world that enables every single human being on the planet to interact with everyone else without needing permission from anyone. That's incredibly exciting stuff. So if you haven't tried it, get involved. It's more than just a speculative bubble. Give it a try.
So for our audience, are there any good news coming here in Korea? I mean, for the last part.
Yeah.
Any news that we can expect from the Bitcoin Cash community maybe?
There's so much great news. So just yesterday in Hong Kong at the Bitcoin Cash Independence Day party we had, they announced Wormhole on Bitcoin Cash, which is a tokenization and smart contract platform for Bitcoin Cash. I think the first tokens went live on the CoinEx exchange last night, for that sort of thing. So tokens and smart contracts are coming to Bitcoin Cash in a big way. And then also just yesterday, Bitcoin Cash processed more transactions in a single 24-hour period than BTC ever has in its entire history in a 24-hour period. So that shows Bitcoin Cash can scale to be money for the world. I wish the BTC guys good luck with their science project, but it's not Bitcoin.
So thank you so much for your time. And as a last comment, I saw you speak a little Korean, so would you care to give your last comment in Korean, if that's not too much trouble for you?
Yeah. 한국 진짜 사랑해요. 삼겹살을 많이 먹어요. Come to Korea. 감사합니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in. That was Mr. Roger Ver, the CEO of Bitcoin.com.
Thank you. Thank you so much. 감사합니다.